Deputy Carol McNeill to introduce.
Thank you, Minister. My question is two parts, really. It's to, you know, ask you whether or what tax or other financial measures are being considered, to other incentive measures, to sit alongside the proposal to have a right to work remotely. And the second part of the question actually is about the impact on financial services firms, recognising how many moved following Brexit and the impact of changing OECD guidance on permanent establishment and tax treatment if some of those employees have moved back to Britain or other places.
The Deputy Minister.
Very much, Deputy, for your question. So I'm taking, Count Corla, if it's okay with you, 10, 35, 38 and 56 together. I'm advised by Revenue that while working remotely does not entitle PAYE workers to a specific tax credit, a combination of both legislative provisions and administrative practices provide relief for remote workers who incur certain expenditure in the performance of the duties of their employment from home. It is acknowledged that remote workers may incur expenditure in the performance of their duties from home, such as additional heating, electricity and broadband costs. Revenue currently allows an employer to make payments of up to €3.20 per day to employees subject to certain conditions without deducting PAYE, PRSI or USC. Revenue have also advised me that the provision of equipment such as computers, printers, scanners and office furniture by the employer to enable the employee work from home will not attract a benefit in kind charge where the equipment is provided primarily for business use. Furthermore, the provision of a telephone line, broadband and such facilities for business use will not give rise to benefit in kind charges where private use of the connection is incidental. Revenue have provided detailed guidance and details of how claims for e-working expenses should be calculated and submitted, and all of this is outlined in the tax and duty manual, e-working and tax, which is available on the Revenue website. In relation to the broader questions that the Deputy put to me regarding the future of these allowances, this is something that I will be considering in the budgetary process. As the Deputy will know, in the TSG paper that we published there a couple of days ago, it did outline an international comparison of our rules and grants and how our schemes stack up versus elsewhere, and it did lay out some options for me to consider. Just in terms of your final point, my department published there just before the summer a publication looking at the impact of remote working and the impact that it's having on financial services and the operation of our economy. And I don't have a sense at the moment, Deputy, that home working has had any more of an impact on the competitiveness of our financial services sector than it has in any other part of our economy. And indeed, you know, jobs announcements that have been made over the last number of days and even today show how many large employers and Irish employers have been able to make home working and employment growth happen together. And it should be a sign of encouragement to us regarding what the coming years can bring as we come up with new ways of working away from the office. So, Deputy, the part of your question in relation to support from working from home, we'll be dealing with that in the coming weeks. And in relation to financial services, while there has been change, I don't believe that change at the moment has been at the expense of our competitiveness. Thank you.